Hi, my name is Drista Nicolae Cătălin, and today I'm going to present you our paper, Are You Wearing a Mask? Improving Mask Detection from Speech Using Augmentation by Cycle-Consistent GANs. This is joint work with Radu Tudor Ionescu. First of all, the task of detecting whether a person wears a face mask from speech is useful in modeling speech in forensic investigations, communication between surgeons, or people protecting themselves against infectious disease such as COVID-19. In this paper, we propose a novel data augmentation approach for mask detection from speech. Our approach is based on training generative adversarial networks with cycle consistency loss to translate unpaired utterances between two classes, with mask and without mask, and on generating new training utterances using the cycle-consistent GANs, assigning opposite labels to each translated utterance. With our work, we participated in the mask sub-challenge of the Interspeech 2020 Computational Paralinguistic Challenge, surpassing the baseline proposed by the organizers by 2.8%. Our data augmentation technique provided a performance boost of 0.9% on the private test set. Furthermore, we showed that our data augmentation approach yields better results than other baseline and state-of-the-art augmentation methods, such as speed perturbation or spectral augmentation. While deep neural networks attain state-of-the-art results in various domains, such models can easily succumb in the pitfall of overfitting. This means that deep models can take decisions based on various biases existing in the training data. Such a notorious example is an image with a wolf being correctly labeled, but only because the snowy background. To overpass this issue, several data augmentation approaches have been proposed by researchers. Nevertheless, not all augmentation methods lead to better results. One cause for weak performances of neural network could be any potential bias in the dataset. A model might consider features specific to other tasks, which are easier to learn rather than feature to desired task. Our data augmentation approach eliminates any potential bias in the distribution of training data samples to the compensation that comes with the augmented data samples from the opposite class. In our case, training samples belonging to one class may have different gender and age distribution than the training samples belonging to the other class, among other unknown biases. Instead of finding relevant features to discriminate utterances with and without masks, a neural network might consider features for gender prediction or age estimation, which is undesired. With our data augmentation approach, all utterances with masks are translated to utterances without mask and the other way around. This forces the neural network to discover features that discriminate the training data with respect to the desired task. In our case, binary classification between with and without mask. As I highlighted before, several approaches for audio data augmentation have been proposed in literature. The most known methods which perform in time domain are noise perturbation, time shifting, and speed perturbation. In the case of noise perturbation, the over-the-road signal S of t is added a noise signal N of t, which usually follows a normal distribution. In the case of time shifting, the raw signal S of t is moved along the time axis with a delay factor t0. The delay could be positive as well as negative. In the case of speed perturbation, the raw signal S of t is dilated or contracted with an alpha factor such that the resulted signal will have a different speed. Lately, methods which perform in time frequency domain have been proven to attain superior results comparing with classical approaches. For example, spec augmentation is a spectral augmentation method with a policy consisting of masking blocks of frequency channels and masking blocks of time steps, such that the network may learn more useful features. Another example is a method of data augmentation based on conditional generative adversarial networks. This method involves creating new training examples with the condition of a certain label from a latent space. Our data augmentation method is inspired by the success of cycle-consistent GANs in image-to-image translation for style transfer. Based on the assumption that style is easier to transfer than other aspects, for example geometrical changes, cycle GANs can replace the style of an image with a different style while keeping its content. In a similar way, we assume that cycle GANs can transfer between utterances with and without mask while preserving the other aspects of the utterances, such as the spoken word. We therefore propose to use cycle GANs for utterance-to-utterance transfer, which in our case is spectrogram-to-spectrogram. The spectrogram X with mask is translated using the generator G into Y hat to make it seems that Y hat was produced by a speaker not wearing a mask. The spectrogram Y hat is translated back to the original domain X through the generator F. The generator G is optimized to fool the discriminator DY, while the discriminator DY is optimized to separate generated samples without mask from real samples without mask in an adversarial fashion. In addition, the GAN is optimized with respect to the reconstruction error computed between the original spectrogram X and the spectrogram X hat. Adding the reconstruction error to the overall loss function ensures the cycle consistency. The complete loss function of a cycle gain for spectrogram-to-spectrogram translation in both directions is shown in the first equation, where G and F are generators, DX and DY are discriminators, X is a spectrogram from the mask class, Y is a spectrogram from the non-mask class, and lambda is a parameter that controls the importance of cycle consistency with respect to the two GAN losses. The second equation describes the first GAN loss, which is the least square loss that corresponds to the translation from domain X with mask to domain Y without mask. Analogously, the second GAN loss equation is defined. As I highlighted earlier, an important loss factor is the cycle consistent loss, which is described in the last equation. The cycle consistency loss is defined as the sum of cycle consistency losses for both translations. In our experiments, we employ a more recent version of cycle consistent GANs, termed You Got It. Different from cycle GAN, You Got It incorporates attention modules in both generators and discriminators, along with a new normalization function called adaptive layer instance normalization, with the purpose of improving the translation from one domain to the other. The attention maps are produced by an auxiliary classifier, while the parameters of the normalization function are learned during training. Furthermore, the loss function used to optimize You Got It contains two losses in addition to those included in the first equation from the last slide. The first addition loss is the sum of identity losses, ensuring that the amplitude distribution of the input and output spectrograms are similar. This loss function is described in the first equation. The second additional loss, which is described in the last equation, is the sum of the least squares losses that introduce the attention maps. Convolutional neural networks attain state-of-the-art results in computer vision, the convolutional operation being initially applied on images. In order to employ state-of-the-art CNNs for our tasks, we first transform each audio signal sample into an image-alike representation. Therefore, we compute the discrete short time Fourier transform as is described in the shown equation. In our experiments, we considered a number of fast Fourier transform points of 1024 and a Hamming window of 512 length. We employed four ResNet models with depths ranging from 18 to 101 layers in order to generate embeddings with different levels of abstractization. For the ResNet models, we used the official PyTorch implementation, where we adjusted the number of input channels of the first convolutional layer, allowing us to input spectrograms with complex values instead of RGB images. We tuned the hyperparameters of the ResNet models on the development set. In order to combine the ResNet models, we removed the softmax classification layers and concatenated the feature vectors resulting from the last remaining layers. ResNet 18 and ResNet 34 provide feature vectors of 512 components, while ResNet 50 and ResNet 101 produce 2048 dimensional feature vectors. After concatenation, each iterance is represented by a feature vector of 5120 components. Regarding the SVM, we train the model on features provided by ResNet models. We choose an RBF kernel and tune the regularization parameter on the development's dataset. Our complete pipeline is highlighted in the shown figure. In the first stage, we train the ResNet models in order to attain the best possible results without any data augmentation method. After that, we add the cycle-consistent data augmentation in the training process of ResNets, obtaining other four new models, which in this case achieve better results. In order to train the SVM, we concatenated the embeddings from networks with and without data augmentation, obtaining a new embedding. Those new embeddings were fed into the SVM in order to find the best hyperplane of separation by maximum margin. The dataset was provided by the Musk-Ausburg speech corpus. The dataset is partitioned into a training, development, and test set. It contains recordings of 32 German native speakers with and without wearing surgical masks. Each data sample, or utterances, is recorded of 1 second at a sampling rate of 16 kHz. In this slide, we present the preliminary results obtained for all ResNet models. First, we note that the augmentation based on conditional GANs reduces the performance with respect to the baseline without data augmentation. While training the conditional GANs, we faced convergence issues which we believe to be caused by the large size of the input spectrograms, which are more than twice as large compared to those used in the original paper. While noise perturbation and speed perturbation bring performance improvements for only one of the four ResNet models, SpecAugment manages to bring improvements for two ResNet models. There are only two data augmentation methods that bring improvements for all ResNet models. Those are time shifting and UGATIT. However, we observe that UGATIT provides superior results compared to time shifting in each and every case. Among the individual augmentation methods, we conclude that UGATIT attains the best results. Since time shifting and UGATIT are the only augmentation methods that bring improvement for all ResNet models, we decided to combine them in order to increase our rank in competition. We observe further performance improvements on the development set after combining UGATIT with time shifting. In this slide, we present the results obtained by various ensembles based on SVM applied on concatenated ResNet feature vectors. Our SVM ensemble without data augmentation is already better than the baseline provided by the compare organizers. By including the ResNet models trained with augmentation based on UGATIT, we observe a performance boost of 0.9% on the private test set. As time shifting seems to bring only minor improvements for the SVM, we turned our attention in another direction. Noting that the validated value of the regularization parameter C is likely in the underfitting zone, we tried to raise its value. This generated our fourth and fifth submissions, ending up at obtaining the best score of 74.6%. In this paper, we presented a system based on SVM applied on the top of feature vectors concatenated from multiple ResNets. Our main contribution is a novel data augmentation approach for speech, which aims to reduce the undesired distribution biases in the data. This is achieved by transferring data from one class to another through cycle-consistent GANs. In the future, we aim to extend our data augmentation approach to multi-class problems by using the star GAN. Thank you for your attention. If you find our work interesting, please go and read the full paper.